I'm Jon Richardson, stand-up comic and team captain on panel show 8 out of 10 Cats, where I'm known as the one who's a little bit OCD.
You've got most OCDs, haven't you?
Well, no, they're not OCDs, they're just correct ways of doing things. If I was sensible, I would say, well, do you know what, it evens out when I get home, but then sometimes I can't remember if I've got uneven...
Oh, for fuck's sake!
For much of my life, I've been on a quest for perfection.
This is how things should be done.
That's horrible.
I'm the first to admit that I'm a little bit obsessive.
Technically, this is a sport, but to me, it's just tidying a table.
But as for obsessive-compulsive disorder, I don't know much about it, or whether I've got it.
It must be exhausting to kind of spend all that effort writing comedy and then go, right, now I've got to sort my shoes out.
Hello, John.
To help me find out, I'd like to meet some of the 1 million people in Britain who have the condition.
We wash our mouths for, like, 2 hours, and it'll be, like, 2 in the morning.
People for whom living with OCD is no joke.
I'd rather not shake hands at the moment.
Fair enough. No, absolutely fine.
We were born with a time bomb ticking in our heads.
Cause of death, obsessive compulsive disorder.
And I hope to discover whether or not I really have OCD. For as long as I can remember, I've dreamt of being a stand-up comic.
Great, so if you want to make some comfortable after your dressing room, we'll come and see you in a minute.
Right, I'll see you in a bit.
Okay, see you then. Cool.
But making my living from comedy means coming face-to-face with some of my compulsions.
The venue stinks. Nothing is symmetrical. There are noises and lights that aren't in the right place. But you can't fix everything, can you? These are my responsibilities, the laughs, and then everything else. It's just a sign of how wrong the world is. This is where they send me to chill out and then they put stuff like this on the walls, which absolutely drives me insane. There's stuff missing, it's not symmetrical. There's two on that side and there's only one on the left-hand side. And then there's one missing in there. If I'm trying to look at my notes and learn my notes and I can see that the papers aren't tidy and at right angles, my brain's just saying, move the Guardian, move the Guardian, move the Guardian. So it's easiest, just line the Guardian up and then I can focus dead ahead and keep my mind just on learning my hilarious jokes.
Please welcome your host, Jon Richardson!
Yay!
It's not just symmetry that bothers me. When I'm walking down the road, I'm secretly scanning the pavement for things that will unsettle me.
So these are, they look the same, but that one's got an extra grid round it. So I need to take all of that one, but then make sure I don't quite go right to the front of that one. But that would all happen in half a second.
I know I'm not the only one who has rules about where I can walk on the pavement, but I've never actually spoken about this to another pedantic pedestrian.
No, of course I haven't!
Comedian Tom Rosenthal of Channel 4's Friday Night Dinner has been aware for years of unusual walking habits.
Hello there. How are you?
Very well, thank you. How are you?
I'm good. Yeah. Should we go for a walk?
Let's do it.
Let's go for a walk in the sunshine.
Let's go for a stroll.
I'm very aware when I'm crossing the road if I've stood on a yellow line with my right foot and not with my left foot.
Yeah.
I'm very aware of that.
Yeah, big time.
Like, if I were to stand on that bit there, I would very much know I'm never going to find that bit of time
again.
Yeah,
this is exactly it. Yeah,
so
yeah.
I'll avoid that.
Yeah. My brain sort of separates stuff like this, a pathway, into different segments. So we've got like a light grey thing here and then your dark grey thing here. And so I've kind of worked this into the way that I walk.
Like me, Tom feels compelled to step on things an even number of times so that he feels balanced.
Yeah, see, this is nice, isn't it?
It's good.
Feel free,
it is good. I'm still getting, you know, things though, like the cracks. If I put my right foot, like, even near it, I want to put my left foot in the similar distance away from the crack when I'm walking and then sort of step over it and do the same the other side.
Should we have a break and then forget
Let's
that
out.
This problem exists for a while?
Let's relax.
Tom has been diagnosed by a specialist as having low-level OCD.
He said something to me about if you do for more than, like, an hour a day, if, like, the stuff that you do adds up to more than an hour a day, you do have OCD, basically. It becomes a significant part of your life, and I think that is definitely the case with me, that everything that I'm doing is infinitesimal and actually takes a very short amount of time because I'm doing it constantly. I clearly do
suffer from it, like, clinically.
Do you feel you're getting worse then, or do you feel you're...
I think, yeah, at the moment I am getting worse, actually, just because I'm noticing new ones. It is worrying. I had this thing when I was watching football, live at the stadium. If I would brush the guy in front of me with my arm, I'd have to do it again. But, you know, he can feel me doing that, so... Yeah. He's going, like, why is this man touching me all the time?
Wow.
It's weird, but...
It's interesting, you're the first person I've ever walked with who has had the same thing as me. Would you say I have OCD?
Well, I have an issue saying I have OCD simply because I know people suffer from it a lot more. Mm. And for that exact reason, I think I actually operate perfectly well and that my life is kind of normal. Mm. However, we clearly both do have, like, compulsions that are abnormal.
That was somebody saying very clearly for the first time something I've been doing for a long time. And it's sort of frightened me a little bit. Now I'm starting to get a bit worried that maybe I do have more irrational ones than I thought.
What concerns me most of all is how my particular ways of doing things affect my relationships with those around me. For the past year, I've been sharing a house with two comics, Matt Ford and Danny Buckler.
How's life?
Life's good.
For me, living here is far from anxiety-free.
This is how I would have it, and this is how it... this is how it goes. See how what... that needs to happen. So this is the source of most arguments in the house. What I do ask is that when you wash cutlery, you then put it in the cutlery holder. We take this over to the cutlery drawer, where we put forks on the left, knives in the middle, spoons on the right, teaspoons at the bottom, facing to the left, steak knives on the far left. This is how things should be done. It's like a beach, just after the tide's washed out.
I had no idea this had been a festering problem, that you'd been smoothing it out.
You never see it happen. You don't come in and find him there, oh, I've got to get this all straight and I've got to get that lined up. It just sort of happens. It's like living with a ghost. I did come in once, one occasion, where this OCD, where I came in and, like, the sauces, you had the tomato sauce, this barbecue sauce, and this HP lined up, and they were all even. But what it looked like is that he'd been squirting them down the sink to try and get them to kind of, in a perfect line.
Johnny's never rude or aggressive, but he'll have his little bits where you can hear him going...
This door leads to my room, but we can't go in there because... I don't like people to go in, so this side of the door I have to deal with messy rooms and stuff that isn't tidy. This side of the door is where I can switch my brain off and know that everything is my choice and where it goes. This is the only little bit of the earth that is mine. I actually get very angry if people, you know, even if Matt and Danny sort of peek their head in the door, I lose my temper.
So do I have a medical disorder? Or am I just an annoying man who has to have things exactly the way he wants? And how early in life do these kinds of compulsions start to take hold? On the North Wales coast lives a teenager who's recently been diagnosed as having OCD. Jon has only just turned 16. But he's already got compulsions that are taking over his everyday behaviour.
Clothes are uneven amount of times, that way it just feels sort of right. Go to unscrew this, I'll do that. And that on the exact side, so I get a whole feel around sort of what the bottle, which is sort of a pointless compulsion.
Hello, Jon.
Hiya. Yeah,
I'm Jon too. How are you? That seemed like quite a careful step.
Yeah, I like to slide my feet an even number of times because it's just sort of the feeling of it. It sort of feels
only
right
on the bottom two steps or on all the steps?
On the bottom two, and then on the rest of them, I'll just sort of do a sort of little slide. But the first two, when I walk through a door, I'll tap twice, once here, like once there. Walk inside the door, tap once here and once there on the opposite side, and then I'll just walk through the door. And then usually I'll slide my feet on this and then walk through. And I'll slide twice on each foot. Every time I go to sit down on the chair, I'd sit like on the end like this, and I'd slide three times on the chair, and then on the fourth one slide backwards.
So you have lots of compulsions, like with sitting and doors and...
Yeah, this would be the same with anything. If I took my phone out of my pocket, I'd slide it before, well, same as me sitting down, really.
When did you first notice things happening?
I was about 6 or 7 years old, and I was getting probably bullied. That sort of, the stress I was in sort of triggered it. And the first compulsion was sort of to the tapping the doors, and that's sort of how it started.
What's the worst it's got then?
I'll have a compulsion every 2 seconds. Like, I'd sort of just like stand on the spot and just not be able to think. I'd be standing there for, I don't know, maybe hours, just like with the amount of stress I'm under, just thinking and thinking what I can do to sort of break the cycle, sort of thing. And it's sort of irrational and stupid as well, but it's just something you can't really control with it.
You know, as you're doing it, that really it doesn't make sense.
Yeah.
But you can't not do it.
Yeah. Well, I'll be washing my hands for like 2 hours, and it'll be like 2 in the morning. I'll just think, I want to go to bed now. I think I can't do it. If I could, I'd cut out the pointless compulsions, like the tapping doors, things like that, on cracks in the pavements.
People will just think, well, why don't you then? Because you could just not touch the door.
Yeah.
But it's very difficult to explain, I guess, that feeling you would get if you did do that. What would happen to you? What would you feel inside?
It would sort of stress me out, and because I was stressed out, it would sort of play on my mind even more and make me do other compulsions. And it's not really something you can just say, right, I'm not going to do it, no matter how much it plays on your mind.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
Nice to meet you.
I'd like to find out from John's parents how much his OCD affects his life outside home.
Thank you very much. What struck me is how sort of constant it seems for him. So it's not, I feel that I have a couple of things I do, but with him it seems from the moment he wakes up to the moment he goes to bed, there are things he's having to deal with.
This is the worry, because it affects his life, really, you know. And you think in future life, how is that going to affect relationships? How's it going to affect career, education? He's done his GCSEs now.
Mm. We're worried about now is how is he going to get on in college? We're hoping he can get some treatment, get some help.
If he can learn to control it and get it just so that it's just now and again, or it's just a few little things he does, then hopefully he'll be able to suppress it and contain it. Because, I mean, I don't want OCD really to be what defines him.
I had no idea that OCD could come on so strong at that age. To see someone who, in an effort to control things and make himself feel comfortable, is actually starting to be controlled by the number and volume of compulsions he's having, I just wasn't prepared for that at all. It just feels like you should be able to go, right, don't do it anymore. 1, 2, miss a few, 99, 100, that's it, finished. And it isn't like that. It's so unclean. And it was the first joke I heard about it was used to say, I never say I've got OCD because it's got the word disorder in it and it seems untidy, which at the time was a flippant joke, which I regret. But now I think if I'm learning anything from this is that it is untidy, it's a mess, and it makes people's lives a mess, and it's not fair.